Thank you for watching videos by Jeff Sibelius and LandAndAirPhotos.com. Time for your first flight with the DJI Mavic Mini. Watch this video on Preflight so your first flight will be a great success. Once you have set up your Mavic Mini, charged the controller and the batteries, and updated the firmware, you're ready for your first flight. Make sure you choose a day for flying that offers good weather. Rain can damage your drone and wind can cause the Mini to fly erratically. Pick a time when it's sunny and winds are under 10 miles per hour. Location is important as well. For your first flight, pick an open field that is free of obstacles and other people. Pay attention to light poles, trees, power lines, and other potential hazards. Once you arrive at your launch site and unpack the aircraft, remove the gimbal lock. It's important that you remove this before you turn on power. This plastic shell protects the gimbal during transportation, but it can actually damage the gimbal if you leave it on the aircraft when you power up. Time to put in the media card. Find the media compartment on the back end of the body. Slide the media card face up into the slot and push it in until it clicks into place, all the way in. Now you can install the flight battery. Open the battery compartment door and slide the battery into the battery bay until it clicks into place. Close the battery door. With your first flight, begin the good habit of inspecting your drone as part of your pre-flight routine. Check the arms to make sure they're fully extended. Inspect your propellers to make sure they aren't chipped or cracked. Look in your motors for any leaves, grass, or other debris. Check your gimbal to make sure it's hanging freely. Look over the drone for any cracks or damage. Check the battery. Is it fully charged? Take a look at your transmitter. Is the device charged? Are the antenna extended so the flat faces are pointed at the drone? This inspection takes 30 seconds, but it could keep you from having an accident and destroying your drone. Place the aircraft on a level spot on the ground. When you place your drone, point the nose of the drone directly away from you. I'll explain why in the next episode, First Flight. Notice how far away I put the aircraft from where I will be standing? It's a good idea to leave a safe distance between you and the drone in case the drone malfunctions during takeoff. Find a spot on the ground that's not close to trees or metal obstructions. Also make sure the spot is free of grass that might interfere with the gimbal's motions during startup. You can try to launch from a sidewalk or parking lot. Be advised that the rebar in the concrete may interfere with your drone, causing a calibration error. One good technique is to put a flat, non-metallic surface on the grass and put the Mini on that surface. A pizza box, a floor mat from your car, even the Mini's case if you got the Flymore package. Now it's time to set up the transmitter. Connect your smart device to your transmitter and place it into the clamps of the transmitter. Connect the cable from your smart device to the transmitter. Our transmitter is ready to go, so now we can turn it on. If the DJI Fly app doesn't open automatically on your smart device, open it now. Now you can turn on power to the Mavic Mini. Remember, for the sake of safety, always turn on the transmitter first, then turn on the drone. When you start the system, you may receive a magnetic interference error from the DJI Fly app. That means something in the ground caused a problem with the connection between the transmitter and the drone. If you get that message, move the drone to another spot where it's free from magnetic interference. Don't try launching when you get that message. Once the aircraft and transmitter are booted up, the Go Fly button will activate on the app, or it will open the camera screen. Before your first flight, the system may require you to do a compass calibration. Click the calibration message. Click calibrate. Then click start. Hold the Mini so it's level and rotate it 360 degrees clockwise. When the app prompts you, point the nose of the Mini straight up and rotate 360 degrees. When calibration is done, a message will appear on screen. Place the drone back on the ground, nose out. preflight is finished and you're ready for your first flight. I've got a link on screen to the first flight video, so click it to continue on with your learning. Before you go, don't forget to subscribe so you'll hear about all my tutorials in the future.